Assalamu alaikum guys, welcome back to Technology Explorer. In this video I am going to show you how you can make such type of animation. If you want to download these parts for your practice, I will leave the download link in the description of this video. And I will also show you how you can make all these parts in SolidWorks. So keep watching this video till end. Let's start. First of all, I am going to design bed. So for that, sketch on front plane and then draw a rectangle. And start it from origin. Define its dimensions. So this width is 300 mm and this length is 600 mm. Press escape button and then from here select sketch fillet command and select all these corners one by one. Fillet radius is 100 mm. Press OK button. Again press OK button. Now go to Features tab and apply Extruded Bow Space command. Extrusion thickness is 60 mm. Now go to Sketch tab and from here click on this arrow below the Sketch button and then select 3D Sketch. Draw a line like this. Press Escape button. Then select this face and this line. Make their relation parallel. Define the distance from this face to this point. It is 35 mm. Also define the distance from this face up to this point. It is 20 mm. Now define the length of this line. 475 mm and press escape button. Now select this face and this point. Make their relation on plane. Next step, draw 3-point arc and start it from this point and draw it like this. Now press escape button and then define the distance from this face up to this point and it is also 20 mm, but we have to edit this dimension. It is 25 mm. Now define distance from this face up to this point. It is 150 mm. Now press escape button and then exit from sketch mode. Next step, go to features tab and then create a new plane. Select this point and this line as a second reference. Press OK button to create this new plane. Then sketch on this plane. Make normal to and then draw a circle and start it from origin. Define the diameter of this circle, which is 40 mm. Press escape button and then draw a line. Press escape button again and from here select trim entities, trim this side of the circle. Then exit from sketch mode, hide this plane and from here select swap cut command in the features tab. Select this sketch as a profile and this line as a path. Then press OK button. Again press and hold control key, select this face and then this face. Now click on reference geometry and then create a new plane. So this new plane will automatically be created in the mid of this part. Press OK button. Then click on this arrow below the linear pattern and from here select mirror. So in the first box select this plane as a mirror plane or face. Then expand these options and from here select cut swap to. Press OK button. Now hide this plane 3, then click on this face and sketch on it. Make normal 2 and then select this arc and this arc. Also select this line and this line. And then press this button convert entities. Now go to features tab and select extruded boss base command. So we have to make this feature in thin, reverse the direction of thin feature, and here is the thickness of thin feature, it is 5 mm. Height of this extrusion is 50 mm. Press OK button. So again we have to create a sketch on plane 3. So click on it and sketch on it. Make normal 2. And then draw a sketch by using line command. Start it from here. Draw one more line. Now draw a 3-point arc like this. Press escape button. Define the height of this line. It is 60 mm. This length is 45 mm. Total length is 150 mm. Press escape button and then in the features tab select extruded boss base command. Drop down these options and from here select mid plane. So total width is 50 mm and press OK button. Now sketch on this face. Make normal 2. Draw a sketch by using line command. Start it from here. Now press escape button and again go to features tab and apply extruded boss base command and press no button. So thin feature thickness is 5 mm. Extrusion length is 80 mm and press OK button. Now select fillet command from here and select this edge, this edge, this edge, this edge and this edge. Fillet radius is 20 mm. Press OK button. So bed is ready. Save this part. Press Ctrl plus N key from your keyboard to start a new part. Then sketch on front plane and at this time I am going to design pin. So draw a line. Start it from origin. Press escape button. Then draw 3-point arc. Again draw a line like this. Press escape button. Now select both these arcs and make their relation tangent. Now define it. This length is 10 mm. This length is 5 mm. Now rearrange this sketch like this. Then define this height 4-5 mm. So now go to features tab and from here select revolved boss base command. Select this line as axis of revolution and then press OK button. Next step, select fillet command, select this face. scroll down. Fillet radius is 5 millimeter and press OK button. Save this part as pin. Again, start from new part, and at this time I'm going to make ball. So sketch on front plane, then draw a circle. Define its diameter 40 millimeter. Now draw a line like this. Use trim entities command to trim this side of the circle. Then in the features tab, apply revolved boss base command. Select this line as a axis of revolution and press OK button. So this ball is also ready. Save it. Now again start from new assembly and let's assemble all these parts together. So first of all, import bed. Then import rest of the things. Now let's change the appearance of all parts. So now select this ball and this face. Make their relation coincident, concentric. Then press space button and select this view orientation. Arrange the ball in the middle of this place. Then right click on the pin and rotate it according to the bed. Now press and hold control key from your keyboard and make duplicates of this ball. Select this face of bed and this face of pin. Make their relation coincident. Now align all these pins together. So select one by one and make their relation coincident. So once again, select this face and make normal too. Now place all the pins like this. So our model is ready for the animation. Next step is that before starting the animation, set the proper view orientation of your model and then expand the mates. Select all mates, then right click and suppress them. Click on motion study one here and from here drop down these options, then select basic motion. So this is the gravity, click on it, and here is the direction of gravity. So at the moment we need the direction, this direction of the gravity in the z-axis. So press OK button. Then this is the button used for contact. Select it and then select all the parts in the assembly and press OK button. From here, select the speed of animation and then press this button calculate. So this is how we can do free fall animation in SolidWorks. I hope you had enjoyed and learned from this video. Thanks for watching and don't forget to subscribe this YouTube channel.